The broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
Hello. Hello, everybody. My name is Natasha Kazatzidou. I am from IDEC, from a Greek organization that is based in Piraeus. We are organizing courses, structured training courses for teachers in the framework of Erasmus+ program. And this is the first webinar of a series of two webinars that is devoted to the preparation of proposals for KA1 mobility projects, and specifically for structured training courses. We will not deal here with other type of projects. Before we start, and make sure that we are all on board in this webinar. A brief presentation of some features of the platform. We are here, we have around 40 people registered in this webinar, and at the moment we have 8 people that have already arrived and listening. I would like to test the function raise your hand. You have in your screen, you see the presentation, the PowerPoint presentation, and you have also a window, a small window with the features of the webinar. And I would ask you now to raise your hand. I can see some people raising hands. Please, if you raise your hand. Okay. Thank you. And now I would like to also present a short poll about your participation in European mobility projects. I will launch a poll, and please answer to the question. You can vote one option. If you have participated in a mobility project, if you have managed yourself a mobility project, or if this is your first time. So, most people have already voted. I will close. We see the results of the poll. We have 60% of people here that are first time doing a mobility project, and 40% that have already done a mobility abroad. They have participated in a mobility abroad. Finally, we have some of the functions of the GoToWebinar platform is that you can pose a question or use the chat. You can use these functions if you want to ask something, and we will receive your questions and we'll answer them at the end of the presentation. So now we're going back to the presentation. What we will talk about today is a general presentation of Erasmus+ call for proposals. And then we will talk about elements of a good proposal, how to select the right course, the right course for your organization and for the participants of your organization. And then at the end, we will present our own offer, the courses provided by IDEC, by our company. The deadline of for the presentation of the proposals is on 5th of February. The call for proposals has been already published in October, and last week we have since last week we also have the guide, the program guide. The program guide is your Bible. You should read it carefully before you start the proposal. And in the field of KA1, we have in the field of structure training courses, you can participate if you are from a school in general education, or a consortium of schools, school authorities, or coordination bodies. Also in the field of vocational education, any organization that is a provider of vocational education or a player in the labor market can participate. And in the field of adult education, organizations provide adult education, non-vocational adult education. All these types of organization can participate in this type of mobility activities. The funding that you get from Erasmus+ program is split into different cost categories, and these are organizational support. This is a sum that you get based on the number of participants, and this is 350 euro per participant. You get a lump sum for traveling cost that is based on the distance between departure and destination, and also an amount for individual support that covers accommodation and substance expenses. This individual support, this amount depends on the country of destination and on the days of your mobility project. The amounts that are eligible for individual support are mentioned in the national call for proposals. They are different for each country, and they are mentioned in your own call for proposals. You will also get an amount to cover the course fees, that is 70 euro per participant per day, and that amount is only for projects in school education and adult education. And with this amount, you pay the provider of your course. And then there is provision for special needs support. If you have participants with need extra money to cover special needs, and exceptional costs that can travel extensive travel expenses if your travel cost is extremely high, then you can ask for more support to cover your travel expenses. That was a very brief presentation of Erasmus+, to be on the same page. So I have covered the very basic of Erasmus+ mobility projects. The rest is something that you need to read the program guide and understand very well the conditions. And now we'll go to the main topic of this webinar, which is how to prepare your own project. And we will start with the elements of a good proposal. If you read the program guide, there are three different criteria for the evaluation of the proposals. And these are relevance, quality of product design and implementation, impact and dissemination. Today, we will talk only about the relevance, the criteria for the relevance. And in the second webinar, that is next week, we will talk about quality of product design and implementation, impact and dissemination, which are more on the project design. Today we will talk about relevance, which is the main criteria that is relevant with the specific courses that you will attend. Now, what you need to pay attention in order to cover the relevance and to make to get the maximum points for your proposal. You need to present a very, very clearly your project objectives that are covering, your project should cover the needs of your school and the needs of individual participants. That means that you need to describe your school in details, and you need to describe the situation of your school, the situation of your area, how many teachers you have, how many students, the profile of your teachers, if this is relevant, in order to justify the need, your need of your organization, of your school. When I say school, I mean educational organization, because the same applies also to adult education organizations. For example, you may present the needs of your school in terms of regional or local development priorities. It makes a difference if your school is in a rural area or in an urban area, if it is isolated, if you have a lot of migrants, if it's a school in special education, if you have inequalities between girls and boys in your school. All these specific characteristics of your school are important in order to present a good proposal. Then you need to present also the individual participants. Who are these participants that will participate in your project? If you have selected them, you will present them with short profiles. If you have not selected them yet, you will present their profile and describe in general terms which are their learning needs. The needs, the specific needs of your school and participants may also associate to a project that you need to move, to go, to start. For example, if you plan to buy equipment, new technological equipment, or if you plan to implement intercultural or inclusion projects, you have specific needs that you need to cover in terms of skills of your staff. You present your European development plan. You need to link the needs of your school and individual participants with the project objectives and also your plan for internationalization. How you will use this new project to connect with other schools in other countries and to reinforce your internationalization plan. Then you need to link all these, the objectives, the needs, with the project activities. Your project activities are some trainings that you will attend, that your participants will attend. The trainings that you will choose should be relevant with the needs that you have expressed. All this should link together. The project, the different project elements should be consistent one with each other. Last but not least, you will stress the need for capacity development, capacity building in your school. That means professional development of your staff. How you have selected courses to attend in order to build capacity of your school and your staff. And now we are moving on the core, which is how to select the right courses for your school and for your participants. We have grouped the criteria for selection, the selection criteria, in three main areas. The first is the relevance with your project objective. The second is the quality of the courses. And thirdly, some practical criteria. In terms of relevance, the description of the courses should provide enough information in order to demonstrate that it fits to the needs of your organization and your participants. That means that in the description of the courses, you should find the keywords, what are the topics, what are the thematic units of the courses, and how they fit with the needs that you have already identified and already mentioned. Then, the target group. The target group of the courses fits the profile of your participants. There are courses that are designed, for example, for primary education students, teachers, or for secondary education teachers, or for adult teachers, or there are courses that are generic. In the courses that are generic, you will pay attention to the level. There are courses that are for introductory level or advanced level. For example, in the field of robotics or ICT in education, there are courses that are for at introductory level for teachers that have no previous experience, and then there are some advanced that cover specific issues. The language of the course is another dimension. Most courses are in English, but you can you probably find also courses that are in French or German or in other languages. The methodology, very important that the methodology of the course fits the needs of your target group. Remember that your target group, the participants, are adults, they are professionals, they have a lot of experience themselves. They will go to learn something specific, and the methodology should be appropriate for them. You will not choose courses that are lecture based or designed for not appropriate, not according to adult education methods. It's important that you choose courses that you have enough information so that you can know what you expect. It's very often the case that the courses are described very vaguely, and you go there and you find something else that is not what you expect. So more or less, this is about the relevance, and then we have some criteria about the quality of the course, and in the quality of the course, the main your main input will be the reputation of the course provider. So you may have recommendations from other participants, from your colleagues, from schools that you have met in different places. There is a source, a big source of information in the school education gateway, where you have the catalog of the different courses and from different providers. And here you can see ratings of the courses. You can also read testimonials from previous participants. This is the first, your first meet with the course, a specific course provider. Then when you will start talking with a specific course provider, you will judge with your own criteria how professional they seem. If they answer your questions timely and accurately, if they support you in preparing your application, if they provide enough information accurate information and precise information. If they provide support, for example, some providers provide give you ready texts to use in your application. At last, you will trust your own instinct. You will build your own opinion regarding course providers, and you will choose the one that is more close to your own criteria. There are also some practical criteria. Of course, the place and the date and the cost, all these things that are important for you to select a specific training provider. You need to look where the courses are taking place. If the place is somewhere that you want to go, if it is accessible by, if it, there is an airport, or you can access, how you can access this place by train or another means of transport. What else you can do in this place? The primary goal of your mobility will be to learn something, to attend the training, but also think about what other things this place has to offer. The second criterion, the date. When you develop your proposal, you will present it in February, but training can be in the school year 21-22. You need to choose specific cohorts of time that you will attend the course in order to make also your planning. There are some providers that have different dates to choose. They have, for example, the same training in two or three different times per year, so that you can choose the period that is best for you. Autumn, spring, summer, winter. You may combine it with vacation, or you may use your school time to take leave for training. That is specific, that you need to think about. The cost. The budget that you have to attend the training is fixed. You know it beforehand. The cost of the training, every cost, normally is published in the vet provider website. You need to analyze this cost and see if it's in your budget. Normally, the costs of the training providers are the fee that they charge, and some providers also charge organization and administration costs or costs for a cultural program. Normally, the accommodation and traveling and all the other expenses is something that you have to pay in addition to the training fee. You need to do a small research while preparing your application to see the related cost and they fit to your budget. Then, of course, is the language that we talked about before. If there are questions up to now, you can use, you can write it down, and we will answer at the end of the session. I see someone that has raised a hand. If you have a question, write down the question in questions, in section questions. And I continue with the presentation of our own offer. IDEC courses. IDEC is a training provider. We work in this field for 13 years, organizing courses for teachers and trainers and staff in education organizations previously in the framework of Comenius and Grundtvig programs, now in Erasmus Plus program. Moreover, we have 30 years of experience in European projects and partnerships in the field of education and training, and we have participated in 262 projects. We have hosted more than 1,000 learners, 1,333 learners, and we have continuously courses throughout the year. We host around 280 learners per year. Finally, we implement courses in four different locations in Greece. What we offer, we have 24 different courses covering all needs, from pedagogical to managerial to project management, innovative teaching methods, sustainability, different fields. And we also design courses on demand if you have a large group. All the programs that we offer are designed and are based on our experience in European projects, and they bring expertise from multiple countries. We care about the whole experience, so we don't only deliver courses, we support the organizations to prepare the application, to prepare before they come here for the mobility. We have excellent administrative support, and we provide also follow-up of for the participants. We have a Facebook page that we group all participants together, and we provide follow-up support after the course. We have a team of qualified tutors, different tutors for different courses, all of them experienced, all of them proficient in English and proficient also in different adult learning methods. And of course, proficient in their field of training. I don't want to go through the courses. This is something that you can see in our website. I will use the last minutes to present the summer school. Is a new offer that we designed for this summer of 2020. We organize a summer school in the city of Chania in Crete. Crete is the biggest island in Greece and one of the biggest, among the biggest in the Mediterranean Sea. And Chania is the city in the west part of Greece, of Crete. We have designed a summer course for two consecutive weeks, late June, beginning of July. In this summer school, we have put 10 different courses, 5 courses the first week and 5 courses the second week. And our aim is to combine learning, networking, and also spending nice time in Crete. In terms of learning, we have the courses that you see in your screen. In the first week, we have the course European Project Manager, Intercultural Competencies, STEM through Robotics. This is a new course that we will offer first time in Chania. Innovative Teaching Methods, Creativity in a Digital World. These are the courses for the first week. In the second week, we have Strategic Planning in Teachers Team, Values Education, Advanced Innovative Learning Methods, Education for Sustainable Development, and the World Art Classroom, Museums and Cultural Landscapes. These are the courses for the second week. Now, this the experience in the summer school is not only learning experience, because we provide also networking, and the networking is being implemented in different methods. We have designed common learning sessions. That means that two groups or more will be together in one class to have a common session. The common session could be something with the same content. For example, intercultural communication is relevant for the intercultural competencies course and also for the European project manager course. Or the common session could be also something that combines content from one course and methodology from another course. For example, we have the course Innovative Teaching Methods, where we have the debate method, and we have the intercultural competencies course, where we have the one topic for human rights. We combine these two courses and we have the topic of human rights delivered through the method of debate. With these common sessions, we will achieve that the participants in different groups will come together and have to work together, and so that they will be able to meet each other and develop links with between them and between their organizations. Other activities that we have designed is an open space. We will devote one time, one session, to have an open space. That is a methodology, a networking methodology, where we will create, all the groups together will create ideas for future projects and cooperation between the participants. And we have a networking event where we will invite teachers and trainers, local teachers and trainers from the city of Chania or from the region of Chania. We collaborate with the regional authority of the region, and we will extend the invitation to local participants to come one morning to meet the participants in our summer school. Lastly, you will have the chance to use this the whole week, the whole summer school, to present promotional material from your own school. That means that you can bring your own banners, posters, roll-up, leaflets, publications, different publications to promote your school and also to network with other participants. These are the opportunities for networking. And lastly, we aim to provide a week where you will enjoy. You will enjoy a lot. First, the whole summer school will take place in the Mediterranean Agronomic Institute of Chania, which is a very, very nice place. It is a village. It's an academic setting with dormitories inside and a lot of classes where we will have the courses and amphitheaters and open space. We will have sessions outside, in the outside space. Here we will enjoy also the Cretan gastronomy, the Cretan cuisine. And the whole package will include also the lunch. The lunch will be in the institute where we will have the training. Besides that, we will organize, of course, the cultural program where we will visit the city, the port of Chania, and we will have also one excursion to enjoy the sea. Chania is famous for the beaches. They have it's a place in Greece with the most top beaches worldwide, not only in Greece but in the world. So that was all about the summer school. You will find more information of our courses in our website, trainingcenter.gr. You will find our courses also in School Education Gateway. We have all our courses are present in School Education Gateway. There you can also see the testimonials from previous participants and ratings from previous participants. And if you need more information, you you will contact our person responsible for the training courses, Mrs. Lila Anthopoulou, at lila@idec.gr. So at this point, I will check if you have any questions. I don't see any questions. If you have any question, please write it in the application. Meantime, I will show you our website and the Facebook page, and if there is no question, I will close this webinar. This is our website, trainingcenter.gr. Here you will find information about the summer school. All the information is listed here. All the courses are listed here. And you can register. There is a link to register directly from all pages in the website. And in the school education gateway, there is a page devoted to the courses that we provide, where you can find all our courses and all the reviews that we have received from previous participants. There are some testimonials also for some courses. If you go down to the pages, there are testimonials that you can see for specific courses. I don't see any questions, so I close the webinar. I remind you that next week we have a second webinar, How to Write a Successful Proposal, which is a technical webinar, and we will tackle specific steps for writing a proposal, specific tips and comments and recommendations for presenting a very good proposal for KA1. Thank you very much for your participation, and I hope to see you also next week.